see, Project Natural as Fuck is underway. And this is where I'm sitting at right now. I'm actually, you know, I thought I was softening up. I think I actually feel a little bit harder, a little bit leaner than I was before. My weight has come down a little bit. I'm more hungry. I'm a lot more hungry than I thought I was gonna be. Like, I do feel thinner. Like, I feel like my neck is thinner. My shirts are fitting a little looser. I feel a little bit, you know, a little more sluggish. A little having a little bit, need a little more sleep than I was. I feel skinnier. I mean, I do. Hands down, I feel skinnier. But I don't feel depressed. I think it's gonna take quite a long time. You know, like, I'd say 12 weeks of being off the testosterone totally before you really start to feel the effects of it. So I don't think I'm gonna have those effects. But we'll see. Who knows? I can tell that I'm, you know, I'm definitely kind of trimming down a little bit, which I really didn't expect. I missed cardio twice this week due to schedules going on and stuff. And yeah, my workouts have been consistent, but while I was traveling last weekend, the workouts weren't super intense or anything like that. They were just kind of getting through, getting a pump, etc. I was deficient in calories pretty much all weekend while I was in Arkansas. So basically, I think you know, I'm still feeling okay. You know, I'm feeling okay. And you know, by the time you guys see this, I don't know if you'll see the other video of why I'm doing this. You know, I think that this is really, and let me just, my thoughts are all over the place right now because there's so much going on right now with the Rich thing, with the Dallas thing, with just things in general, like people contacting me left and right asking about why I'm going to go natural for the Olympia. And I do believe that you should come off. I'm not saying that you should come off forever. I'm not saying that I'm going to be off forever because I'll be back on after Olympia, but everybody that has been doing the fucking steroid thing has been doing it consistently nonstop for years now. Guys don't come off anymore. And it was always like when I first started in the 90s, guys came off. I was instructed to. I was taught how to. Like, that's the way they did it. And I really feel like you need that time for your body to heal. It's like if you cut yourself and don't let it heal and you keep fucking cutting yourself, it'll somewhat heal, but eventually that fucking finger's gonna fall off if you keep fucking with it. You know, so you have to let your body heal. And the idea was to get to the Olympia, be natural for 4 weeks, show people that you can be off for 4 weeks with no PCT, so if you do the PCT for 8 weeks, and then you're off for 4 weeks, that's 12 weeks you're fully off, you don't feel that bad. You know, you're doing the PCT, you shouldn't really lose much of your gains, and then you go back to do whatever you do, but people are scared to come off. You know, they're scared to take time off. They're scared that their physiques are gonna go backwards. They're scared that they're gonna feel like shit. They're gonna lose strength. They're gonna not progress. You know, let's face facts. The guys in the 90s used to come off and progress from show to show and get better. These guys nowadays just get bigger. They don't get better. The muscularity is not there. The solid fucking lean mass is not there. They just keep getting bigger and more blown out from the insulin and other shit that they're taking and not coming off, and they don't look better. They're getting bigger, but they're not getting better. So the idea is, I don't want to be bigger. I want to be better. You know, going into my 50s, I mean, I'm only 41 now, but heading into my 50s, I want to be better. I want to be athletic. I don't have to worry about, you know, whether or not I'm going to have these crazy side effects later on if I can keep my TRT to a minimum, come off every now and then, give my body a break off the TRT itself, which the doctor's cool with. You know, they're always cool with that. As long as you're not staying off and have this blood work that comes back all fucked up because you're off. So we're going to do legs today. I got to run a bunch of errands. I got to get my phone screen replaced because the fucking phone screen broke. I dropped it and fucking thing cracked all over the place. Apple, can you guys make something that doesn't fucking break? I know other companies do it. Why don't you guys fucking maybe talk to them and see if you can buy the fucking technology off them to put on your iPhone? I don't know. Maybe that would be helpful. I don't know. So we're going to take Brady for a walk, get our day started. We got Nutrition Solutions Pancakes up in 3, 2, 1. For a little while now, I've been having some problems with my hip joint, my knee. Obviously, I've talked about my knee, how I smashed a dude in the head with my knee and have soft tissue damage in my knee. And I always made fun of people for the tights, the guys wearing the spandex pants. I always made fun of them. I was just like, that's fucking stupid looking. You look like a ballerina. It's just fucking dumb. And I've noticed more and more people wearing them, guys wearing them with like basketball shorts over them or like running shorts over them. And I was like, what the fuck is the point? And I actually asked people, like, why do you do that? And a lot of people were like, I don't know, everybody's doing it. That's what they said. Everybody's doing it. I was like, well, I'm not fucking do that. It's fucking stupid. I'm not going to do that. So I actually get an email and someone had recommended getting some of the compression tights, the Nike compression pants. It keeps the joints and the muscles warmer. Which I'm like, well, wouldn't you overheat? And they're like, no, but it breathes through the fucking thing. I'm like, Jesus Christ. I'm like, whatever. I'm like, do you actually recommend this? And they're like, yeah, give it a shot. So I'm like, fuck. So when I got two pairs of these fucking compression pants and some Nike basketball shorts that will just, you know, fit over them. And I'm going to give it a try today. And I'm definitely into trying anything that would not be a medication to help my joints and the muscles themselves perform and stay warm during the workout. I'm like, I'm usually warm during the workout anyways, but I don't sweat. Like, I never sweat. No matter what, I can be on the bike, I can fuck it. It doesn't matter. I don't sweat. Like, when I go outside in the heat, I sweat. But when I'm working out, I never sweat. You know, very little bit. So maybe this is going to be something that keep the muscles warmer, they can perform better, they can recover better, and they just, you know, will give me help with my joints. That's what they're saying. I don't even fucking know. Like, it sounds like bro science to me, but if it fucking works, it works. I don't give a fuck. We'll give it a shot, right? So here is the Nike Pro, I guess. Nike Pro, I guess this is the brand that I fucking bought, because I heard these are, like, the best ones. So, I've never wore tights before, actually, except for my Batman costume for fucking Halloween, so I guess we're just going to see how these go. So there's my Nike Pro compression tights that I'm going to be wearing to the gym to train legs in. And like I said, everybody says that they're actually really good for support. I don't know what that means for support, and to keep your legs warm, which is going to help with my joints, which is the reason, biggest reason. And I'm not going to wear them like that. I'm going to actually wear these over them. I used to make fun of everybody for this type of style, but guess what? You got to do what you got to do, right? So, this is how we're going to roll to the gym today, to train legs. Hopefully this helps a bit. We'll see. I don't know. Time to get geared up for the gym. No pun intended. So we're going to start with EAA Max Energy, which has caffeine in it. Only caffeine. That's the only stim that's in it. And a scoop of Intracell 7, along with Vasogorge and Pyrex. Now, this combination is off the fucking chain pump. The caffeine that's in the EAA Max doesn't cause the same vasoconstriction as something like adrenal rush or something like that. So it actually allows more blood flow because the capillaries are actually open more rather than constricted. They're vasilized. Vasilized. I'm bad with fucking pronouncing it. Anyways, the capillaries are actually bigger, which allows more blood to flow through them. So what I'm going to do is actually do the pyretic, which helps with your endurance through the workout, which you feel 10 times more endurant. Vasogorge, which also helps with the pump. It's got glycerol and stuff in there. You got the highly branched lactodextrin that's in the Intracell, along with more glycerol and stuff. It's the nitrosigenes in there also. Plus the caffeine, which is the mild stimulant, and it's a time-release caffeine, so it doesn't slam you in the face and doesn't give you a crash. What I think I will do is I'll throw in a baby aspirin with that too, which actually thins the blood a little bit. Now, you guys may be saying, like, Jay, this is an awful lot of stuff to do for pre-workout, and that may be true, but here's the deal. Those little things that you do will, in fact, get you better, faster results than if you're not doing them. And a lot of people say, oh, you just need to eat and you just need. That's true, but I don't want to be the average person. I don't want to look average. I don't want to be the guy that walks in the room and people go, who gives a fuck? I want them to go, well, this guy looks pretty good. Hey, what about working out? I want them to approach me. I want to be able to teach people by my body being a business card. And that's kind of what I think all personal trainers should aspire to do, is your body is your business card. If you don't look fucking the part, people are not going to ask you. You can't educate them. It just works like that. So you're going to educate more people if you don't look normal, you know, which I want to look fit, in shape, athletic, not like just the average fucking gym goer. So I do stuff like this. It works for me, always has. I've been doing it since I was fucking 15. And I've been, you know, a more highly athletic looking individual since I was in high school, you know, doing this stuff. So I just, you know, I fully believe in it. So we're going to rock this stuff out. Get ready to head to the gym and do legs today with our new compression shorts on. I'm looking like fucking Batman's little cousin over here. I feel like one of the Power Rangers that got cut from the squad or something wearing this shit, but we'll see. That tastes so good. Pink lemonade and watermelon Intracell. But this is the mango Intracell, I don't wonder why. Pink lemonade and mango. What are you doing here, Bubba? You want to go for the walk? Then put sneakers on, then we go for the walk. We think, go for the walk, go outside. Let's go outside, good boy. You're a good boy, hey boy. You're a good boy. Yeah.
Go to the right, go to the right. Atta boy. He understands, he does. The spot, buddy. Go ahead, find a spot. Come on, find the spot. Find the spot. I don't give a fuck. Find a spot. Yeah, right.
Jerry, make it square.
Make it square. This is Kenny. He works over here at a gym in Fairfax. Kenny, what is your single, like, your favorite, your absolute favorite? Like, you can't get up in the morning, can't wait to get up and push play. What's your favorite YouTube channel?
I like Street Training. Hey.
One exercise in, I'm definitely fucking warmer, there's no doubt about it. I'm definitely, absolutely, positively sweating more now. I'm not even getting the muscle cramps like I normally do, so score one for the tights. Clark in the gym. Blackstone and Primeval do get along. So Aaron, what is your number one favorite YouTube channel that you watch?
Blackstone.
workout over. So what you saw was three exercises of four sets of four drops. So each set was four sets within one, because you're doing the whole thing, the whole 10 to 12 reps or 8 to 10 reps or whatever you're doing. It's not like you do 10 reps, then three, then two. It's literally four sets within one set. So it's 16 sets per, three times 16. I'm not good with math, but it's a lot of fucking sets. And for those of you that are like, well, no, Jerry, they're not real sets. Who said one set had to be spaced out between another? Like, who said that one rep had to come after another? It was Mike Mentzer that theorized that when he came up with his rest pause sets, he said nobody said one rep had to be done exactly after the other. You could do one rep and then rest for 10 to 15 seconds, do another rep, and they would still count towards the same set until you finished the set and recovered fully in between. So based on that theory, which, you know, again, a lot of theories out there, you know, science says. Anyways, so I'm definitely warmer. You guys saw Aaron Clark in there. And, you know, he's training. I'm not sure if he's going to compete this year or not, but Aaron and I have been friends for a while now. We actually competed together in 2011. Great guy, good dude. And it's cool coming to the gym and seeing these guys, you know, day after day, and they're supportive and they fucking kill it every day in the gym. And, you know, no matter what your goals, you know, I'm not a bodybuilder anymore, but the guys in the gym that are doing bodybuilding and stuff are just as supportive as if you were. So time to grab something to eat and finish up with clients and stuff. We're on to the next day tomorrow. We're out.